Hello everyone, welcome to my class today. Today I will be dealing with the next medical surgical disorder, that is atelectasis. So atelectasis means, so the definition is, it is collapse of the alveoli. So collapse of the alveoli, so alveoli is also a lung gland. So collapse of alveoli or lung glands is called as atelectasis. Okay, so this is caused due to deflation of the alveoli, okay, so alveoli resulting in lack of gas exchange. Okay, so you know the alveoli main function. So if you see one alveoli is like this, okay, so this is alveoli and there is a pulmonary capillary coming from the heart. Okay, so when the pulmonary capillary is coming, so pulmonary capillary will bring deoxygenated blood, that is increased carbon dioxide, whereas in the alveoli there will be increased oxygen. When we take, that is when we inspire in during the process of inspiration, oxygen will enter inside, so alveoli will be inflated with oxygen and the pulmonary capillaries will have increased carbon dioxide. So when they come to the alveoli, there will be diffusion. Diffusion means molecules or gases will move from higher molecular area to the lower molecular area. So carbon dioxide, which is high in the pulmonary capillaries, will enter the alveoli, and the oxygen, which is more in the alveoli, will enter the pulmonary capillaries, and thereby they go to the pulmonary vein and they will come to the left side of the heart. Okay, so this is the main function of the alveoli. So in atelectasis, what happens is there is collapse of the alveoli. Collapse of the alveoli means the alveoli is not inflating, that is when oxygen is entering inside. So when oxygen is entering like this, the alveoli has to inflate. So this is the normal lung, so alveoli will inflate so that they can do the work of gas exchange. Gas exchange means this oxygen and carbon dioxide gas will get exchanged. But in case of atelectasis, so you can see this is the atelectasis lung and this is the normal. Okay, this is the normal lung. So in atelectasis lung, you can see the alveoli glands, because they are deflated, that means they are not getting inflated, they are permanently deflated, and the alveolar spaces will, sorry, the pleural space will increase, but the lung will become collapse like this. That is called as atelectasis. Okay, so you would have understood. So it is deflation of alveoli, because of this gas exchange is not taking place. Next, coming to the types of atelectasis. Okay, so in the types of atelectasis, the atelectasis is divided mainly into two types. One is called as obstructive atelectasis and other one is the non-obstructive atelectasis. Okay, so as the name suggests, if there due to any obstruction in the air passage, okay, so due to any obstruction in the air passage, the oxygen is not entering in the alveoli, so the alveoli is deflated and collapsed, then we call it as obstructive atelectasis. Whereas non-obstructive means it may be any other cause other than obstruction of the airways. Okay, so due to any other cause other than obstruction of airways, if the alveoli are deflated and it collapses, then we call it as non-obstructive atelectasis. Okay, again, obstructive atelectasis is divided into two as lobular atelectasis and segmental atelectasis. Okay, so that means in the area where the obstruction is present, okay, so according to the area where the obstruction is present, we classify into lobular and segmental atelectasis. So you all know the lungs is divided into lobes and the lobes are further divided into segment. If the obstruction is in the lobes of the lung, then we call it as lobular atelectasis. So if the obstruction is in the segments of the lung, then we call it as segmental atelectasis. Okay, so according to the obstruction, they are called as lobular or segmental atelectasis. Okay, then coming to the non-obstructive atelectasis, they are again divided into several types. Okay, so in non-obstructive atelectasis, the first type is compressive atelectasis. So compressive atelectasis means here, as the name suggests, the lungs are compressed due to any air or any fluid or anything is filled in the thoracic cavity or the pleural cavity, which is causing compression of the lungs. Okay, so due to any air or fluid filled in the chest cavity. Okay, so that is maybe it can be a pleural or thoracic cavity. So when it is due to compression, we call it as compressive atelectasis. Okay, next is adhesive atelectasis. Okay, so adhesive atelectasis is, as the name suggests, adhesive means there is some adhesions within the adhesions means the alveoli is sticking, okay, sticking to each other due to some chemicals. Okay, so mainly this occupational chemicals like asbestosis, sarcoidosis, so these are all certain chemicals where the person, due to occupation, they will constantly get exposed to that area. So these chemicals can stick the alveoli. Okay, so the alveoli is sticking to each other and thereby they cannot inflate during inspiration. Then we call it as adhesive type of atelectasis. Okay, next type is the crick cortical. Okay, so crick cortical is due to any scarring of the lungs. Okay, so this is due to any scarring of the crick cortical. Atelectasis means due to any scarring of the lungs. That means, so as I said in the previous in empyema class, the pus and other any infection, if it is in the lungs, the other infections will go into the pleural cavity, and this pleural cavity, after formation of pus, they will start producing fibrin, and this fibrin will result in scarring, and this scarring scar tissue will become hard and tighten on the pleural membrane. Okay, so because of this, the pleural cavity and the lung membrane will become very stiff and hard, so they cannot inflate and deflate. Okay, so because of that, the air cannot come inside the alveoli because of the stiffening of the lungs. Then we call it as crick cortical type of atelectasis. Okay, and next is acceleration atelectasis. Okay, acceleration atelectasis is mainly common in all the flyers. Okay, flyers means those who like pilots and other air hostess who will be frequently traveling in the flights. Okay, so when they frequently travel in the flights, so this is because there is change in the air in the ground level and in the high level. Okay, so the atmospheric change in the pressure of the atmospheric air. Okay, pressure of atmospheric air, sometimes the alveoli cannot resist or cannot sustain the sudden change in the pressure, where for a few minutes or for a time being, the alveoli will not get inflated and they remain deflated, and that is called as acceleration type of atelectasis. Okay, I hope you have understood. Compressive means there is something filled in the pleural cavity which is compressing the alveoli. Adhesive means inside the alveoli there are something which is sticking and thereby alveoli cannot inflate properly. Crick cortical is there is scarring of the lungs where the lungs is becoming tightened, so proper inhalation and exhalation of air is not taking place. Because of that, the lungs are getting collapsed. And acceleration is mainly in persons who are frequently traveling in the flights. Due to the changes in the atmospheric pressure in the ground level and in the high level, the person may go for atelectasis. Okay, so these are the types of atelectasis. Okay, so next coming to the causes of atelectasis. Okay, so causes and risk factors of atelectasis. Okay, so in the obstructive type, okay, obstructive type, there are only main three causes. One is any foreign body aspiration. Okay, this is many common for children. So when they suddenly take some something abnormal foreign body, that is any coins or any peanuts or something they accidentally put in the mouth, but due to their improper swallowing reflex, it is going into the respiratory tract and it can obstruct the alveoli. And next can be tumor. Okay, so tumor is any cancer in the airway passage. There is growth of that cancer. This can also obstruct the air passage, and thereby it can cause obstructive atelectasis. Okay, and next is increased mucus secretions. Okay, when there is more mucus secretion, these mucus will obstruct, will accumulate inside the alveolar glands, and they can obstruct the air to come inside because of that inflation of the alveoli will not take place during inspiration. Okay, so these are the main cause of obstructive, and non-obstructive causes can be, okay, so this can be due to any occupational pollutants or chemicals. Okay, as I already said, these chemicals can cause scarring of the lung glands. Okay, and it can be due to any compression. So this compression can occur because of any chest trauma or any chest surgeries, or it can be any disease conditions like emphysema, bronchiectasis, okay, empyema. So these conditions where the fluid can go outside and accumulate in the pleural cavity. Okay, so due to some lung diseases. Okay, so these are all any lung diseases can cause atelectasis. Okay, then it can be also due to pleural effusion. Okay, pleural effusion is increased fluid filled in the pleural cavity, and it can be due to pneumothorax. Pneumothorax means air filled in the pleural cavity. Okay, so increased air, okay, so air filled in pleural cavity is called as pneumothorax. Okay, so these chest trauma, chest surgery, emphysema, bronchiectasis can cause, and otherwise scarring of the pleural membranes. Okay, and diseases like sarcoidosis, asbestosis. So these are more common in the person who is working in mines and other area where cement factories. So where when person are more exposed to the chemicals, they will cause this. They can cause the atelectasis. Okay, other than this, there are certain risk factors of atelectasis. So has any risk factors? So aging. So in old age, due to degeneration, the alveoli cannot hold it properly. There may be muscular degeneration where the alveoli cannot hold properly. So when the person is very elderly, he can go for atelectasis. Okay, and next is due to premature babies. Okay, so in the seventh month of the pregnancy, the surfactant will be produced in the lungs. Okay, this is surfactant is a protein, like is a molecule that helps in keeping the airways open. That means alveoli to inflate and to deflate, to the muscular strength of the alveoli is given by this surfactant. So in premature babies, the surfactant may be in a lesser amount, so they can go for atelectasis. Okay, and other conditions like if the person is very obese, or if the person is bedridden. Okay, so any bedridden patient for a long time, if they are not doing any walking or exercise, because in a same position, if a person is for a long time due to that position, and also due to the heavy weight in obesity, they can compress the lungs, and the person can go for atelectasis. Okay, and next it can be due to smoking also. So smoking also, again, it is a chemical which can go and accumulate in the alveolar spaces. These chemical will form like a scarring or stain, and because of that, the alveoli cannot inflate and deflate, whereby patient can go for atelectasis. Okay, and then one major risk factor is the general anesthesia. Okay, so when patient is going any undergoing any surgery, we give them general anesthesia. Okay, so during general anesthesia, the person's lung functioning is done by a ventilator. So suddenly, when the person rising from general anesthesia, the alveoli cannot change. That is, the alveoli cannot suddenly it cannot accommodate to the change, and thereby it can go for atelectasis. Okay, so these are the causes and risk factors of atelectasis. Okay, and next coming to the pathophysiology of atelectasis. Okay, so pathophysiology of atelectasis. So as there are two causes, one is due to any obstructive causes like foreign body, tumors, or mucus. Okay, so there is some so in the lungs, if there is okay some tumor or mucus or anything which is obstructing anywhere in the bronchioles or in the bronchus, air cannot enter properly into the lungs. So only if the air is entering properly, alveoli can inflate and deflate. Okay, so because air is not entering, they are not inflated, and because of that they can go for collapse. Okay, so that is so any foreign body, they cause obstruction of bronchus, lobes and segment of the lungs, and because of that decrease air is entering the lungs and alveoli. So alveoli cannot get inflated, they will be deflated. So that is deflation of the alveoli, and when the alveoli is deflated and it is not doing the function, it will collapse. That is called as atelectasis, and alveoli main function is to do the gas exchange. Okay, as I already said, it has to transfer oxygen and carbon dioxide, so that function cannot be done. And when you come to the non-obstructive causes, okay, so non-obstructive causes can be due to any scarring, pleural effusion, any surgery, or any pneumothorax which is filling in the pleural cavity or the chest cavity. This will cause compression of the lungs. Okay, so lungs is getting compressed. So when the lungs are getting compressed during inspiration, the air cannot properly enter the alveoli. So decreased ability of the alveoli to inflate during inspiration. So because they are not inflating, they will be deflated, and there will be collapse, and there will be impaired gas exchange. Okay, so this is the pathophysiology of atelectasis. Okay, next coming to the signs and symptoms of atelectasis. Okay, signs and symptoms. So as for every disease, patient will have dyspnea and severe chest pain. Okay, so that is because of the tightening and person inflation is not there. So you will have dyspnea and chest pain and increased workload for breathing. Okay, that means patient has to take in air very difficultly, so that is called labored breathing will be there. So other than this, if the patient is having any infection or inflammation, there will be fever, chills and sweating. Okay, and if there is any increased mucus, there will be cough and sputum production, and this sputum can also sometimes be mixed with blood. So blood in sputum is called as hemoptysis. Okay, and patient can have headache. Okay, so due to increased work for breathing, patient can go for headache and fatigue. And when you auscultate the respiratory area, you can see there is respiratory crackles. Okay, crackles are abnormal sound. You can hear crick crick sound. This is due to air beating on the obstructed tumor or any foreign bodies. So in severe cases, if the patient is not having oxygenation, then the person can go for hypoxemia and hypercapnia. Hypoxemia means decreased oxygen in blood. Hypercapnia is increased carbon dioxide in blood because gas exchange is not taking place. Okay, and because of that, all the organs will not get the enough oxygen. So patient can go for organ dysfunction. Okay, multi-organ dysfunction. Okay, according to the type of organ which is getting affected. Okay, multi-organ dysfunction, like if the cerebrum is affected, patient will go for altered mental status. And if the renal is affected, there will be change in urination and the renal function. According to the organ, where the oxygenation is not taking place, that organ will get affected. Okay, next coming to the diagnostic findings. So in diagnostic findings, first you have same way you have to collect history and physical examination to identify what type of atelectasis, whether it is obstructive type or non-obstructive type, and then you have to do a CT scan. So in CT scan, if there is any obstruction, it can be revealed. Okay, and same way chest X-ray. In chest X-ray, if you can see any pleural and ultrasound. Okay, so both chest X-ray and ultrasound of chest will show if there is any pleural effusion or any pneumothorax or any injury to the chest. Okay, so that can be identified. And next you can do a sputum culture and sensitivity, that is sputum analysis will be done to identify if there is any infection. Okay, because in other lung disorders like emphysema, empyema also, patient can go for atelectasis. So to identify that, you will do a sputum culture and sensitivity. Okay, and the confirmatory test will be bronchoscopy and bronchial wash analysis. Okay, so in this you will identify if there is any mucus. Okay, so you can confirm the atelectasis. Okay, bronchoscopy means it is a fiber optic lens like tube. Okay, this tube has a fiber optic lens in the end, the other end will be connected to a TV like monitor, and the fiber optic lens will go inside the patient's bronchus. Okay, and then this the parts of the bronchus and the wherever the airway the bronchus is going, all the parts will be magnified and showed in a TV, and with that you can identify if there is any obstruction, if there is any infection. And once there is infection or anything, they will aspirate the fluid from that area. And if there is a tumor also, you can identify if there is a tumor tissue, they will take the tumor and then send it for investigation, and in that you can confirm what is the main cause of atelectasis. Okay, so these are the diagnostic findings. And finally coming to the treatment. So as any treatment, so first we have to start with antibiotic therapy. If there is any infection, so drug of choice is ofloxacin and levofloxacin. Okay, so all ofloxacin, levofloxacin, so these all will treat the infection. And next is, this patient will have breathing difficulty and less oxygenation, so you have to start with the oxygen therapy. So either by CPAP is continued positive airway pressure, or by a mechanical ventilation. Okay, so mechanical ventilation in order to replace the oxygenation of the lungs. Okay, and next is to bronchodilator therapy. So in case of any mucus or anything is obstructing, you have to dilate the bronchus. So drug of choice is theophylline, deriphylline, aminophylline. Okay, all phyllines are methyl xanthine group of bronchodilators. And mainly these patient, if in case there is a high mucus secretion, you have to remove the mucus secretion. Okay, so this mucus secretion removal can be done either by suctioning or steam inhalation or a postural drainage. Okay, so these are all procedures you will do in order to remove the excessive mucus from the patient's lungs. Okay, so this is about the atelectasis. So finally you have to do nursing management. So in nursing management, only thing you have to do is you have to relieve the secretions if there is any secretion, and mainly oxygen therapy support the patient, and then nebulizer therapy in case if there is more secretions, to remove the secretions you have to teach nebulizer therapy, and teach the patient on chest physiotherapy like deep breathing exercises and coughing exercises, and then you have to tell diet. So mainly these patients initially they have to take only clear liquids because there is less oxygenation to all the organs, so even digestion will become digestion needs oxygen, so patient cannot digest high solid food. So you have to start with clear liquid, then progress to liquid and semi-solid diet. Okay, and then in case patient is going for bronchoscopy, then assisting the patient for bronchoscopy has to be done. Okay, so mainly bronchoscopy will be done in order to see if there is any mucus secreted. So assisting in bronchoscopy to clear the mucus, or they can also wash the bronchus. Okay, and in case if the patient is obese or bedridden, okay, we have to give some simple exercises on the bed. Okay, this will improve the mucus clearance. Okay, otherwise other vital signs and meeting the needs of the patients at the bedside are same as other patients. Okay, hope you understood my class. Thank you for listening.